before I even started to treat Sherman's with stretching and other techniques, I had a sense of wanting to be stretched out by something like this, one of these medieval torture contraptions. When I first began to treat the condition myself through things like yoga a few years ago, I was drawn to stretches that emulated this effect. I now know that what I was really seeking was the release of tension that the structural kyphosis imposes on the musculature, fascia, and nerves that surround the spine and run along the posterior chain. As you can see, the kyphotic curve in the mid-back puts compensatory pressure upon the lumbar spine or lower back and also tilts the head and neck forward. Because of the interconnected nature of the posterior chain and the body as a whole, these structural imbalances affect not only the spine but also the lower body. Shortness and tension in the sciatic nerve, for example, which connects to the spinal cord and goes on to innervate the hamstrings, has been associated with the development of the Sherman's condition. Even if you don't suffer from a structural kyphosis, modern Western lifestyles tend to cause what the guys over at GOTA refer to as front chain dominance, as opposed to back chain dominant spines that we can see in indigenous people, children, and babies. So, an ordinary pike stretch would look something like this, basically attempting to touch your toes while keeping your legs straight. This stretches the calves, hamstrings, glutes, and lower back, inadvertently providing us with some neuroelongation of the sciatic nerve. However, the mid and upper spine hangs quite passively and even emphasizes the structural imbalances, especially if we were to continue to make gains in this typical pike pose. To Shermanify the stretch, we want to raise the arms and shoulders up, almost with the intention of pulling them back. This can be aided by using a rope or resistance band. In contrast, the chest wants to continue to push down and towards the legs as in the typical pike pose. This is the effect of straightening out the kyphotic hump and also releasing tension in the chest, which can result as a compensatory effect of the kyphosis. It is important here to not let the ribcage flare. This can be achieved by pulling the lower back up, correcting for the hyperlordosis, and using the abs to hold the anterior core together. Once in this position, the aim is to drive the upper body forward at whatever angle your range of flexibility affords you, allowing for a stretch along the entire posterior chain, like a self-imposed and safe medieval torture contraption. Of course, it is important to not go beyond your own range of motion and overstretch, which can only be discovered through careful self-exploration following incremental increases in range. It's also important to supplement rigid stretches like these with dynamic movement that emphasizes the spine and acts as a spinal lubricant, but we'll save those for the next video.